I wanted to show you guys something really cool that I've been working on for months that I'm really excited about, and I hope you guys share my enthusiasm. That just so happens to be the thing I'm currently wearing, which is this lovely Hall & Brown hoodie. Of course, Hall & Brown being the company of the guy who built my house, that being Mr. Charles S. Brown. The hoodie is based on the 1892 catalog. It's something that we have a copy of, and actually all the machines inside the hood are from that 1892 catalog. So the hoodie is a representation of that book. So something that ties directly to the history of my home and to the company and to really Mr. Brown himself. And of course the idea to use Hall & Brown on a hoodie at all, I think makes it serendipitous. I mean, we're using the original owner's brand to fix his house. And so I think there's something extremely, I don't know, beautiful about that, poetic almost. It's a quality product and I'm happy, you know, and I would really like to think that Mr. Brown would be happy that his name is on something that is actually a really cool piece. So the plan is, for whatever amount of money we end up raising selling these hoodies, we'll directly go to the repair of the Mansard roof, which as some of you may know is a very, very expensive endeavor. So this is a way you guys can directly contribute to helping this old girl get her crown back beautiful and brilliant. A link will be down in the description, guys, if you guys want to grab yourself one of these beautiful things. If you do, we appreciate it. We thank you guys so much. It does go a long way to helping us achieve a facelift for the old girl. So thank you guys so much for listening to my silly little spiel about my lovely, lovely new hoodies that I'm quite excited about. And so now let's get back to your regular scheduled programming. Hello everyone and welcome back. Most of the progress you guys are gonna see this week is from the exterior of the building, which I've been dying to do ever since I talked about going and getting that stuff in Baltimore. And this week I got to do a wee bit of that without going and studying in Baltimore. So let's get into a little bit of that work and I'll be right back with you guys to talk about some of the stuff we've gotten done and what there is still to do. Okay, so what I'm doing right now, and I've already done a little bit of it just to see how it was gonna go. Sorry about the airplane noise. But essentially what I've got here is a masonry chisel and I'm trying to repair this huge crack, much like this one, which is even bigger, or here, or any of this stuff. So I'm trying to learn how to repair the front of the building. These problems we had because somebody decided to paint it. And it's old and stone wears over time. So essentially I've got a toothed masonry chisel and I'm just cutting out the section that I know is bad. How I know it's bad is by tapping it and hearing if it's hollow. So the sound here versus, so you can kind of hear it's, so there's a little bit of feedback. You can tell that this is, well, hollow. I mean, obviously you can see the stuff falling out of it too, which is a pretty good example of why it's bad. But here, I've basically cut around until I've reached good stone underneath, which is what I need. What I'm gonna do is I've had this special masonry stuff that finally did come in. And the reason I'm doing it while it's starting to get dark is because it's a south-facing wall and I cannot use this stuff above 90 degrees Fahrenheit. It's been very hot this week. These next 2 days though, Saturday and Sunday, and tonight, Friday night, it's cool enough that I actually try and attempt this. So this is gonna be my first little patch. We're here, right here by the front doors, and I'm gonna see if I can get this stuff to work. So this is the product I'm using. It's from Heritage Restoration. It's a limestone mortar. And so essentially what we're gonna do is we've dug this out to about half inch all the way through and we're gonna fill the area. But I have to actually mix this in two different ways. I need one that's a really, or well not a really, but a pretty wet mix. And then I need a drier mix. But as I mix those, I'll show you what I'm talking about. And so the first mix is gonna be a much drier mix. The idea is to mix it so where it's about the consistency of like wet sand on the beach. So you don't want it to be super duper wet, but like what you would build a sandcastle with essentially. But you see it's kind of clumping. And so it's like sandcastle sand. It's about what you want it at least that's what the instructions say. Again, I've never done this, so learning experience for me and you. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take some of this that I just mixed, and I'm gonna put it in a different cup. Reason being is this is the top coat that you build the patch with, but we need to take this and get it a lot wetter than it currently is so we can put a first coat on here, because again, just like plaster, this will suck a lot of the moisture out of it and that won't bind directly to that. So you have to get a nice wet coat on it first. Now we're gonna start by bringing our ball out here and pushing this into the corners first. Try not to waste too much material here because the stuff isn't cheap at all. So we're just gonna, best we can, push it in there. Now as we're doing this patch, we are going to overfill it, so we're going to get more in there that's actually necessary. Whereas we're going to come back later and screed or scrape that top layer of that off. It's starting to kick off and dry, which is perfect. So all we're really trying to do now is use this straight edge and pull the stuff that we've overfilled off very slowly, kind of meticulously, little by little. You know, we're not trying to take it all off at once, but then trying to flatten it out with the existing stone. So you need a long, something long and straight. I happen to have my trowel that I use for plastering. Clean it with plaster, of course, but then essentially you hold it straight up and down to it and then slowly come across it, take little bits of material off until you have what you're looking for.
So my plan today is to attempt to fix this corbel. But before I can do that, I have to fix this because I've made myself a very nifty little template. Just got two pieces of plywood together. That's the plan, but we gotta fix this first. So use the templates that I made to create a new corbel, and then we can go down the line and fix all the corbels. But this one's first because this is free of paint and it shouldn't be too terribly hard. So let's get at it, shall we?
Okay, it's 10:45. How you feeling?
Do you know where your kids are?
Yeah, they're all inside. Are you gonna do the little fixes at a later date? You're not gonna keep doing this, are you?
No.
Okay, I was like, it's late. It's late for you.
All right, ladies and gents, we're out in the hot, hot heat, and it is the next day, which is why you guys are getting this video on Tuesday. I worked quite late into the night, till about midnight last night, shaping the corbel, but we'll get to the results of that in just a moment. But first, let's go through repair by repair and see the progression of how I got better using the material after each iteration. So let's start with the first one. So right here by the door, front door, is the first repair I got on. And it's all right. It's not my favorite of the repairs, of course, but it is also the first one. I can tool and sand down, essentially, some of the stuff that's not quite perfect. Like this edge needs a little bit of work still. But overall, I think for the first patch, not too terrible. And it's certainly better than what it used to look like, which is very similar to that right there. This is the second patch. as you can see, which went much better than the first patch. Or I don't know, I guess I got the hang of it. And my edge here, I think, is something of beauty. Let me, if you go this way with it, you can kind of see. It's quite straight, quite square. Of course, I had good reference because the stone here was in much better shape. That corner over on the other side over there, I had to kind of make up. But, you know, pretty happy with it. You know, if you didn't know this was a patch, you might think there was some odd wear on the building right here, but, you know, to be honest, it's a little cleaner than most of the stone, because most of the stone still has this really, really, really stubborn paint on it, which will be fun to get off. But, you know, to know that I've stopped this area of the building from wanting to collapse, and again, that's what it looks like. I mean, huge chunks, like I can pull this whole chunk off. You know, like, this is terrible. This is all going to be dug out. This is the one of the really big problem spots, but what you're seeing right here and how bad this was and cracked and crumbling was exactly what this corner was doing too. And we're back to a stable wall. Then for my last day of patching, we have this. I actually didn't notice that before. That's interesting. But that's not really that big of an issue. It's just a little tool mark, essentially. But I think that for the most part, the patch came out pretty nice. Looks pretty good. Certainly the showstopper right now is this corbel I've got on here. Now I am missing a little edge here, and I've got a little blowout right here. But for the most part, that's looking really nice. Like, it looks perfect. I mean, look at the one next to it. And this thing was really stubby. This one was worse than this one when I started on it. So having these nice, straight, crisp lines, the profile came out really nice. Of course, this bottom section here still needs some work. It blew out when I was working on it. So there's still a little bit of learning curve with this material. But, you know, in the 4 days I worked with it, I've gotten pretty all right with it pretty fast. And I, you know, this is all very, you know, skill-based. Like, this is artistry. This isn't just throwing something together. I mean, obviously I have templates to work from, but I'm rather, rather happy with the results and how that came out. I think it just looks really good. Like, it's always been there, which, I mean, most of it has been, but a good portion of this is built up new material. And it's, you know, hard as a rock, because it is a rock. With all of that, of course, it is just the tip of the iceberg. We have, that's the corbel we did. And of course, there's another one over here, and then three here and two up there. And of course, the first floor is the only one with corbels. We have a bunch of them up there as well. I think another nine. And then there, of course, there's all the sills and everything else. And there's a few more blowouts there. Most of the really bad damage was actually at this bottom ring right here. So since we have most of that repair, we're basically done. I do think there's a little bit in this corner here that needs to be done. And of course, once I get the paint off there, who knows what's actually behind all of that paint. I'm sure we'll be having more fun with this stuff in the future. But of course, to know that I can repair it and that I can do it myself is, well, it's massively rewarding. And, you know, I'm just happy that we can take the next step to get the old girl looking good. You know, if I talk about the Mansard in the way that, oh, you know, that's her crown, I want to get the crown back on the old girl. Well, we can think about this as her facelift, you know, getting her makeup all prettied back up, and oh, we're a step closer to that, and that feels good. And also is way less expensive than I thought it was going to be. The products are still very expensive, but since I'm able to do it myself, well, it saves a lot of money, and oh, she's going to be pretty. Also, for anybody who is doing a limestone facaded building, or if it's got blocks, or essentially any part of your house that has limestone on it, if you see somebody coming in to, or you hire somebody coming in to repair that for you, make sure they are using something like this that's a like material, so it's like limestone, or in this case it is basically limestone, it becomes limestone. If they start using something like Portland cement is a much harder material then limestone, and eventually your limestone will give around the Portland cement. Portland cement's not a very good fix for limestone, so that's why I spent so much time researching into this stuff. But this seems like it's the real deal, so you know, only time will tell how long this repair will hold, hopefully forever, but yeah, that's the reasoning why I chose this stuff. So that's the episode this week, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed.
Hope you guys had a wonderful week and hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your week. Quick sneak preview. Check out what we got in. New windows. On that note, see you guys next week. Bye-bye. Take care.